let me cling to you, Jesus. Just let me cling to you, Jesus. Let me cling to you, I give it all
Jesus, there's no
Restore the healing.
Father, we give you all the glory, all the praise, and all the honor. We love you. Be with us this day. In Jesus' name, amen. We will now be going to a time of worship in the Word. So I invite you to open up your Bibles to John 15, 9 to 17. Once again, that's John 15, 9 to 17. John 15, 9 to 11. As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things I have spoken to you, that my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be full. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you are always with us and that you abide in us. Put a greater desire within us to abide in you. Teach us again what it means to abide in you, to live in you, and to have your word live in us. Jesus, teach us again to obey your commandments with the fullness of joy, that as we take steps of faith to obey you, your joy will be made manifest and your word will abide within us. Jesus, you said that as the Father has loved you, so have you loved us. The same amount of love the Father has given to you, so you have given to us. Help us to comprehend and understand the depths of your love and your desire to see us abide in you. this is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, that someone lay down his life for his friends. Jesus, your commands are true and just, and as the body of Christ, we commit to seeking after you and obeying your commandments. You command us to love, and you show us how to love. You gave your life for us on the cross because you love us. You did not have to save us, but in your great love for us, you revealed to us what the greatest act of love is, and you showed us just how much you love us. We praise you and we thank you for your great love. Show us again and again how deep your love is for us.
Concerns are mine, thy concerns are so.
Father, you've shown us how to love. Continue to teach us, continue to show us. Give us revelations, Lord, of how you love us. Teach us to obey your commandments. Teach us to love one another. Pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you.
Father, we want to see your glory and power in our lives. We want to see miraculous wonders, God, that only you can bring. Invade this place. We invite you into this place. In Jesus' name, amen. We will now be continuing with worship in the Word. So I invite you to open up your Bibles to John 15, verses 14 to 17. Again, that's John 15, 14 to 17. John 15, verses 14 to 15. You are my friends if you do what I command you. No longer do I call you servants, for the servant does not know what his master is doing. But I have called you friends, for all that I have heard from my Father I have made known to you. Jesus, we thank you that even though at one point we were against you and a slave to sin, by your blood we are now set free. By your blood we are now called friends of God. Father, never let us stray from your word, but let us continually rejoice in obeying your commandments, that we would rejoice in every single revelation you share with us through your word. We thank you that you do not leave us to our own devices, but as we abide in you, you reveal your good and perfect plan for our lives. Let revelation be spoken to us through your word.
Thank you.
15 verses 16 to 17. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should abide, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give it to you. These things I command you, so that you will love one another. Jesus, we did nothing to earn your love. We did nothing to be worthy of you, but you chose us and you made us worthy. Jesus, you are worthy of all praise. Let us never forget your commandments to love you and to love one another as you have loved us. Let fruit abound in our lives as we abide in you, fruit that will last for an eternity.
When you have chosen me to bear good fruit, you have
We thank you that you invite us in to abide with you, to be with you, to spend time with you. Fill this room with your presence. Continue to flow through this room like a river of life. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you. Lords, we live to worship you. We will now be going into a time of intercession for North Korea. We will be declaring different aspects of God over North Korea and the people of North Korea. I invite you to come into agreement with my prayer and then follow up with your own intercession. Heavenly Father, you are a God of justice and righteousness. Your wisdom and discernment is unmatched. Your judgments and decrees are true and just. You do not tolerate wrong, but protect those who love you and bring swift justice to all evil. Let revelations of justice and righteousness flow through your church in North Korea. We pray that as your people reflect on you and your promises, you would teach them to walk in and proclaim the justice and righteousness of God wherever they go. Let's pray. Faithful and your promises never fail. Let hope rise in your people in North Korea. Let them know that they are not abandoned. But just as you heard the cries of the Israelites in Egypt and answered, you will hear the cries of your people in North Korea and answer. We break every spirit of despair in Jesus' mighty name and declare hope for your church. Let your faithfulness be made known throughout North Korea. Let's pray. Thank you. Heavenly Father, there is nothing in this world that can stand against you. No power of hell or scheme of man can come against you, and nothing can assault your throne. Let your glorious power be made known in North Korea. Father, let your power go out to destroy every work of the devil and every evil that oppresses your people. Break every chain and loose every prisoner. We pray that as your power goes out, every grip and foothold of the enemy is cast down and freedom would reign in North Korea. Let's pray.
Thank you.
Your rule and reign shall never be denied. We pray that every person within North Korea would recognize your sovereignty over the earth. We pray that revelations of your rule would draw multitudes to you as they come to see your great and incredible love for us. We declare Philippians 2 over North Korea, that every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Let's pray.
Awesome rest of the day.